morning, dear students. Yesterday we started the new schedule, that is schedule number 5. In that we started the lesson water. Okay, we discuss about uses of water and importance of water. So today we will see the next point, that is the sources of water. Now see here, the word, it is given the sources. Okay, sources of water. See here, sources of water. So what do we know about the sources? Anyone, just to recall it. See how you are giving answers in the class, the same way, wherever you are sitting, there only you give answer immediately. Okay, what do you know about the sources? Sources of water. Okay, good. See, sources of water means what? From where we are getting this water? How we will get the water? Water, okay, water is available, water is very important for us. There are so many uses of water, importance of water also we discuss. But how this water comes? Okay, what are the major source of water? How we are getting this water? Okay, so that is known as a sources. Means from whom we are getting the water, that is known as source. So how we are getting the water? The major source of water is rain water. What is rain? See, rain is a source of water. If rain will be not there, then how we will get water? Will get water? No. So rain is a source of water. Then see, this is the major source of water. If anyone will ask you what is the source of water, the most commonly major source of water, that is a rain water. Okay, now this rain water means when the rain comes. See, in our area, mostly in the Konkan region, okay, we know that at a certain months, means suppose now June, July, okay, August, September, these 4 months, most probably rain is here in these areas. Okay, so we know that 4 month rainy season, 4 month winter season, 4 month summer season. Means we divided this part because we know after the May month, definitely the rain will come. Okay, so this rain is a major source of water, and the rain water is the purest water, natural water. See here, I tell the point, rain water. Rain water is the purest form of natural water. Okay, means rain water is a pure water. So you will say, madam, if it is a pure water, then we can drink water. See, the first rain water, in that, what happened? So see, in our surrounding, many dust particles are there. Okay, so when the rain falls, so that time, these all the dust particles are mixed in that rain water, because of the industries, whatever the smoke comes out, in that smoke, so many harmful gases are present. Okay, that all the gases are mixed in that rain water. So it is not a pure water. Because of that, the impurities increase in that water. So it is the impure water. But after some days, whatever the rain comes, that is the pure water. So it is known as a rain water. It's the purest form of natural water. Okay. Then the next, so this is the major source of water. The first major source of water is rain water. Now the second one is the surface water. Now surface water means what? See, which water present surface of the earth, on the surface of the earth, that water is known as a surface water. Now which one will come in that? See, first river and lake water. Okay, what will come? River and lake water. River, everyone know river? Good. And lake. See, some river and lake water, it is present on the surface of the earth. See, now also in your surrounding, if you will see, the rivers are there. So, okay, and mostly in a rainy season, it is the flowing, means water. And sometimes because of the river, if it is heavily raining, then floods also come. Okay, So water is useful also, and sometimes it is harmful for also. So now we are discussing about the uses. So first we will discuss what are the uses of water. Okay, so surface water means the water which are present on the surface of the earth. That water sources are known as a surface water. Okay, so this first one is a river and lake water. They are present on the surface of earth, so they are known as a surface water. And see, but because of the so many impurities, means if it is industries are there, then the sewage water. Now sewage water means what? The dirty water. In that, so many impurities are present in that. Sewage water means that so many impurities are present, and that water, what in the industries, what they are doing, that water, it goes in, it is in a river water, and because of that, the river water gets polluted. Okay, and because of means now the river water we are drinking, plants and animals, okay, they are also drinking that water, and because of that the so many diseases cause. If we will drink the impure water, and then so many diseases cause. So what the commonly now we are using purifier, it is there in our home, okay, but most of the villages, those are living in village. I'm not telling all, but those are living in village. So what they are doing? They are boiling water. When you will boil the water, then all germs will kill. That you know only what are the purification techniques of water. Okay. So because of that, it is that this polluted water, so many diseases spread. Okay. And those diseases spread by water. So it's very important point. Those diseases spread by water, that all diseases are known as a waterborne disease. Okay. Sometimes what happens in question paper, the questions come, which of the following is a waterborne disease? Then we are thinking, what is a waterborne? Waterborne disease means what? Those diseases spread through water. Okay. By water, the way of that spreading disease by water, that all diseases are known as a waterborne disease. Okay, you write down this sentence in, suppose now you are taking the notebooks, then in notebook you just write down this sentence. Those diseases spread through water, that all diseases are known as a waterborne disease. Now which diseases are spread by water? See here some examples I wrote here, that is the 20, then chlorella and then typhoid. Okay, these diseases are called the waterborne diseases. See here. Okay, sometimes river water also contains the germs, and that can cause the diseases. And because of this, all the diseases spread because of the polluted water. So that diseases are known as a waterborne disease. Okay, now the next source of water that we will see, that is a sea water. Now see, sea water, it is present in a large amount. Fresh water is very less. This river water and lake water, fresh water means this water we can use for our daily purpose. But this sea water, it is, we are not using in our daily purpose. Why? Because it contains a lot of salt. Means what? In this salt present, this is salty water. If you will drink that water, then you will know the taste of that water. It is a salty water. Why? Because salt is present in that. See, sea water is a salty in taste and is called as a saline water. See, why it is called as a saline water? Because it is salty. Means why? In that the salt is present, and because of that it is known as a saline water. Okay, a large amount of sea water present, but that water we can't use in our regular life, means for drinking purpose, for washing utensils and all. For that we are using this fresh water. River and lake water is a fresh water. Okay, but the more amount of water present, that is a sea water, this we can't use. Why? Because in this salt is present. Okay, and because it taste is a salty, so it is known as a saline water. Now see, the next source of water, that is underground water or subsoil water. Okay, underground water or subsoil water. Now underground, now see, these are surface water, means those water sources are present on the surface of water, surface of earth, that are known as a surface water. But now here underground water or subsoil water means now those water is present under the ground, below the earth surface, that water is known as a underground water. See, the water present below the earth surface is called as groundwater. Okay, see here, principle. Below the earth surface means water is present below the earth surface, that water is known as a groundwater, and the level of water is called as a water table. See, you know that the soil, in the soil lesson 5th standard, that time you drawn the diagram, okay, topsoil, subsoil, bedrock, okay. So after the subsoil, means the first topsoil is in, after that the water level, means what the level of water, how much amount of water. See, this diagram is given in your textbook, just to see that diagram, okay. And after this lecture, draw that diagram in your notebook also. So that water is known as a underground water. And see, the boring, borewell, you know, na? So how the water comes in borewell, that is only the underground water, means which water is present under the ground, that water we are using for drinking purposes, so that is also the fresh water. Okay, so this is the underground water or subsoil water. So here only today we discuss this rainwater, surface of water, and underground water. These three sources we discussed today. Just read related to these points. It is given in your textbook, and draw this diagram in your notebook. Okay. And if you will face any difficulty while reading, if any point you will not understood, then that point you just ask me or send me message, that we will discuss on the next lecture. So remaining point we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.